So the problem that we were given is that long-term Crunch users, they don't have sufficient access to the Crunch tips, which are the things that go on the very end. They're basically a consumable item. They wear out. There's not really like a way to get around that because they're in constant contact with the ground for years. And so Transitions is asking basically for a design and manufacturing method for Crunch tips that can be produced locally in Guatemala, but it could also be expanded to different areas.
All right, so we got our stakeholders. As you said, we got Transitions Foundation in Guatemala. Their main interest is, as you'd expect, producing tips that are durable, cheap, and making wood materials. Same goes for competitive manufacturers. And then you have POP King, who are interested in many of the same things, durable, cheap. They're interested in global expansion, bringing this to different countries besides Guatemala. We were also able to talk with Alicia Contreras, an actual Crunch and Crunch tip user. Her personal interest in the project is for one, you know, sort of personal use. If we can create a Crunch tip that is cheap, works, and is durable, then that's good for her. She also works with the Foundation for Empowering Disabled Women. So disseminating this technology to there would be next. And also disseminate it to her hometown in Mexico. Similar thing for the individual Crunch users in Guatemala. They want something cheap that will last and is easily replaceable. And that's where we come in, trying to make a compromise between all these different needs and things.
So, I'll talk about what we've observed so far. So, fortunately, we haven't been able to talk to Transitions, our main stakeholder, because we're having issues, so we're talking about it today. But we did get into contact with the Mathematical Friends, Alicia Contreras, as we mentioned before, and she's also disability rights leader. She's been affected by polio since 82, so she's been using machines and wheelchairs for a long time. So she was super useful. I got to talk to her over the weekend. And the main takeaway is that current affordable crutch tips wear out unevenly and are super slippery. So like, in addition to like the problem with grip outdoors, we haven't really thought about like the indoor use, so that tips are able to not stick in the tip. So for example, we're looking into using tires as a community of that all with our conversation with Alicia, that didn't sound as like a great alternative because also there's marks around indoors. So basically indoors versus outdoors use. She talked about strong, flexible, and light crutch tips, so like weight is an issue. And yeah, then also through our research, we looked into rubber vulcanization processes and other rubber production processes, and we looked into curing. We talked to our mentor into rubber curing processes, and sort of identify different factors that we can like test for the durability of our rubber, so like tensile strength, elongation, and grip, and hardness. And then sort of also main takeaway from our conversation with Alicia is the Betterment Crunches design. It's called the Tornado Crunches, and what's beautiful about it is that there's a couple of main tips here. So that first part that's in contact with the ground remains stable, and then the crunch like sort of moves around. So that gives like even sort of wear and tear to the crutch tips is much longer. So as opposed to 2 months, which is then Alicia's problem, it goes to 2 years.
So our current problem statement from basically Alicia's point of view is that affordable crutch tips have programmed and wear out immediately, and then that causes a very short lifespan, and that's something we'd like to fix. We expect this problem statement to be revised once we talk to Transitions. We would like to reflect more of their views because they are a principal stakeholder. But at this point in time, this is what we have as our statement.
Okay, so it's good to work on. We'd like to talk to Transitions. mentioned that there is a company which is already making very good fish chips, right, which lasts up to 2 years. What's the problem with their product? Is it not
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So,
$60.
the fresh chips, the ones that are imported into Mexico because that's where it kind of back in Asia, the like good-ish one, the last 2 months, cost $2 a pair. And these Tornado crush chips, those last 2 years, cost between $40 and $60 a pair, which is actually more expensive for the amount of time. They probably grip better, but they're prohibitively expensive. And she buys them when she's in the United States, and then goes back to Mexico. And she mainly uses a wheelchair when she's in